Hello, this is Sheshachalam from Astro Guide Mysore. Today let us go through one of the well-named yogas known as the Parijatha Yoga. This is also equivalent to Raja Yoga. It gives all the necessary comforts, the facilities, the luxuries, the social status, many other things, including most importantly wisdom, which is very rarely found in many of the yogas. So wisdom is found in Gajakesari Yoga, Parijatha Yoga, Sasa Yoga, all wisdom with regard to high level thinking. So that is there in Parijatha Yoga, and it is effectively present. If it is present in the chart, then this particular yoga will manifest in the middle and the later part of a person's life. It does not manifest in the early part of the person's life, that is when he is a teenager or in his early part, like 30 years. So this will manifest the middle part and the later part, that is till the end of life. It's a long, huge yoga. Once it sits, it's there. So the formula for this yoga, what is actually the the criteria? This can also be called as the double dispositor yoga. It's easy to remember. That is, the Lagnadipati, the first point is, I'll just explain and then write this, then it will be easy for you to understand, or else this will simply go blank. Let us say Lagnadipati is posited in a certain house. So let us take this. I took this Lagna instead. Okay. I'll take this Lagna, Scorpio Lagna. And the Lagnadipati is posited in some sign. And the lord of this sign is posited. This is in the demon only I'm talking. This is the first level, first criteria. The Lagnadipati is posited in some sign, and the lord of the sign, that is the dispositor of the Lagnadipati, is posited somewhere else. Here I have simply made it exalt, but anyway, I am just giving you the reference. So the dispositor of this particular planet is of importance, where it is posited. So if the dispositor is actually Chandra, that is moon, if this moon is posited in a Kendra, Kendra is 1, 4, 7, 10, or in a Trine, 5, 9, from the ascendant, and if it is posited in a Kendra or a Trine, the yoga manifests. But if the yoga has to be strong, then it has to be either its house of exaltation or its house of Moola Trikona. So this is very important. So with regard to that, or its own house. So the criteria comes like this. Lord of sign posited by the lord of the sign posited by the dispositor of the ascendant lord should be placed either in a quadrant or a trine which is its own house or exaltation sign or Moola Trikona. This is the first criteria. This is not such an easy thing to, I don't know whether this is getting focused. Just check it once so that I'm just writing it down below. I think it's getting focused, right? If it is focused, it's enough.
It's okay, you can repeat once.
Till here, right? It's getting focused till here. Thank you. So my wife helps me in everything. So just because I did not know whether this is getting focused, I just started writing it. Anyway, I'll just repeat it once again. The lord of the sign posited by the dispositor of the ascendant lord. The dispositor of the ascendant lord here is Jupiter, and the lord of the sign posited by the dispositor of the ascendant lord. Lord of the sign posited by the dispositor, that is the lord of the sign posited by the dispositor, is moon, and it should be present either in a Kendra, that is 1, 4, 7, 10, Trikona 5 and 9, including 1, 1 is already included here, which should also be its either its own house, sign of exaltation, or Moola Trikona. Only then the first criteria of the Parijatha Yoga is applicable.
We will mention this in the description box.
Yeah, we will. This I think we should do for all the yogas. We should put the criteria in the description. I will do it. We will go and edit it and I will put it there so that it will be easy, because what we tell, you know, sometimes people will not be able to understand. So in text, I think it will be easy. So the second criteria is, you should understand this now easily. I have written D9 because the second criteria involves the Navamsa. The same thing, the law of the sign posited by the dispositor of the ascendant in the D9. That is, now Mars is in the second house here. The lord of this particular sign, if in D9 it is posited, let us say, so this is very important. The lord of the sign of the dispositor, that is, now we are talking about this part, the dispositor of the ascendant lord. The dispositor of the ascendant lord is Jupiter, and where it is posited in the Navamsa has to be taken. But anyway, this is Chararashi, so it starts from itself 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it is in the 7th Amsha in this particular place, that is in the Ashlesha Nakshatra, 2nd quadrant. So it is placed in this particular sign in the D9 chart. And who is the dispositor of Jupiter? The lord of Capricorn, that is Saturn. And when Saturn is posited, let us say, in the D1 chart, coming back to the D1 chart, this is Rashi, Tulya, Amsha, and Amsha, Tulya, Rashi. We go there and come back. So the dispositor of the ascendant lord is Jupiter, and its position in the D9 should be referred, and the lord of that particular sign in the D1 chart, if it is in, once again, in the Kendra or Trikona, and being its own house, sign of exaltation, and Moola Trikona. Here Saturn is in the Moola Trikona, or even in the own house, depending on the degrees placed. So it's one of the strongest Parijatha yogas. So here what happens is, in the D9, you have to add here, in the D9, I think we will put this in the description, so it will be better, I don't have to write it down. So this is Parijatha Yoga in definition. So this yoga gives rise to comfortable life. First, most important thing is peaceful, comfortable life. This is very important. Peace. Peaceful, comfortable, respectful. That is because social, no? This is social. And they are also intellectuals. You can also say, in certain cases, I have done some research on this. I suddenly went into and did some research on the charts which are available with me. I have not gone into further charts, but still, with the available resource, I have understood that people like, you know, actors who have come up late in their life and become famous, if we refer those charts, you can see that they have late rise in their life. Into even commercial aspects, respect, see, actors get respect because of the fame associated with the society. The same way politicians, some people don't go into politics in the young age, they go into it in the older ages, after they finish their service. Like for example, people have done army service, they have come back, retired as major or some, you know, wing commanders, and then after coming from the Air Force or the Navy, they come and join the political party, they want to serve the nation. So, until they were in the army or the Navy, nobody knew their name. So now they come back into the politics, now everybody knows their name. So knowing the name, you know, this is a different type of a fame. I will call this as social recognition. Social recognition, because of their good work and good intellectual status. So, thank you very much.
Sir, can you give one more example?
One more example of Parijatha Yoga, yeah?
Okay.
Example 2.
Let me go to another ascendant then.
Yeah.
This is example, second example. I'll do for both cases.
Yes.
So, let me take Aquarius ascendant. The ascendant lord, I have to put it somewhere where I'll put it somewhere, just like this. I'll put it in the 8th house. And the dispositor of the ascendant lord is Mercury. And if Mercury is posited in the 7th house, the dispositor of Mercury is Sun. And if Sun is also there, and it is not combust and it is giving rise to a strong Parijatha Yoga, this is considered one of the strongest Parijatha Yogas. One of the strongest Parijatha Yogas. Because people always feel they have this conflict, thinking that Saturn, the Lagna is Saturn, how come Sun is going to give you a Raja Yoga? This will surely give Raja Yoga. Though it is posited in the West, it will surely give a Raja Yoga. This is a very strong Parijatha Yoga. So let me do another one. So this ascendant lord is here. So, the dispositor is Mercury, and this Mercury is placed in a certain house here. So, let us say this particular Rashi starts from the 9th. So, 1, this is 2, 9, so 9th is this house. So, from here, the 9th house, from there the Navamsa of Simha starts. I am going a little fast because this is the second example. So, from there the Navamsa of Simha starts. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So this is the span of this particular thing. So if Mercury is placed here and the dispositor of Mercury is Mars, and if Mars is placed here, it gives rise to one of the strongest of Parijatha Yogas. And why? Because Mars is very well placed in its own house. And the dispositor, you can again check it here. The first point is the Lagnadhipati going to a particular sign, and the lord of that sign sitting in some other house, and the lord of that sign should be in the Kendra or a Trikona from the ascendant. That's a great thing if it is in its own house, Moola, Trikona or Exaltation. Second point is the Lagnadhipati sits in one particular sign, the dispositor is Mercury. We don't have to see the Rashi, but the dispositor of Lagnadhipati in the D9 chart is placed in one particular sign, and that dispositor should be well placed in the Rashi Kundali. So this is the second example which actually gives rise to Parijatha Yoga. Check out with your charts, and if you have any doubts, you can send me your birth details in the comments. I will check out whether there is Parijatha Yoga in your chart or not. Thank you.